Hello everyone, I'm Anita with Anita by Design and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be making a men's vest. Recently I made a vest for my husband for an article that I wrote in the Social Death magazine, and a lot of you liked the vest, so I wanted to come here and show you how to make that vest. We're going to be using Simplicity 1506 for the vest. Now, this pattern is sized for husky boys and men. So if you need a smaller pattern, then the alternative I'm going to suggest is Simplicity 8023. The instructions are exactly the same. So if you use this one, you'll be able to follow along with me while I sew using this pattern. All right, so this is the one that we'll be using. And let's talk first about the fabric choices. Now, when you look on the back of the envelope, they give you suggestions for fabric that you can use for your vest. And some of these suggestions are brocade. That's the first suggestion, and that's the fabric that I used in the first vest that I made for my husband. The others are flannel, laundered cottons, baby cord, batiks, broadcloth, lightweight denim, corduroy, poplin, twill, and velveteen. Now these are suggestions to give you an idea of good choices to use, but you're free to choose whatever type fabric you want. I do suggest a medium weight fabric because I think they work best and they feel good. Thicker fabrics are okay if you choose to do that, but for me, for my personal preference, I like medium weight fabrics for the vest. Now, this is a lined pattern. Both patterns are fully lined, so you're gonna need a lining, and I suggest a lightweight fabric for your lining. Of course, I mean, unless you want a thick fabric, it's totally up to you, but my suggestion is a lightweight fabric for the lining. Now, for my outer fabric, I let my husband choose his own fabrics. For the vest I made for him with the brocade, he chose the fabric, he chose the buttons, and I wanted him to choose it because I wanted it to be something that he liked, okay? So for this vest, same thing, I let him choose the fabric, and we went downtown Los Angeles to Michael Levine. They have an area called The Loft where they sell all remnants, and they're just all in boxes and on top of the tables, so you really don't know what you're getting. So we picked up, or he chose this one, and it reminds me of a brocade, but I'm not sure if it is, but that's what it reminds me of. It has that feel. So I'm gonna use this for my outer fabric for the vest. And then for the lining, he chose this for me to make him a shirt, which I haven't gotten around to doing, so I'm gonna use it as the lining for his vest. And this is gonna be a pretty casual vest for him to wear on top of a t-shirt or something. All right, so you're gonna need your fabric, your lining. You're also gonna need interfacing, and make sure you choose an interfacing weight that will work well with your fabric. So I'm using a medium weight fabric, so I chose the medium weight interfacing. All right, so that's it on your fabric. Let's talk about the tools or some of the supplies that you're gonna need. Now, you're gonna need all of your regulars. You're gonna need your scissors, fabric, and paper. You're gonna need your transfer tools to transfer your markings onto your fabric. Whether you're using the tracing wheel and tracing paper, you're gonna need your chalk liner, or maybe you're using pencils or markers, whatever you choose to use. Your pattern weights, if you use those. Of course, your pins you're going to need. Let me just say something that I forgot to mention in the beginning. For those of you who are new to sewing, I suggest you go and watch my beginner's sewing tutorial or beginner's sewing course before following along with this pattern, because I will not be going into all of the details of sewing while we're constructing this garment. So if you are very new and you don't know how to sew, I invite you to go check out my other tutorials on my channel so that you can learn how to sew before doing this, and then come back and join us. All right, so I want to introduce you guys, or actually not an introduction, because you know about this. You're going to need a point turner because we're going to be turning out the points on the welt. So make sure you use that or have that handy. And then for those of you who don't know about this, these are called tube turners, and these are used to turn fabric right side out after it's been sewn together into a tube, thin tubes. Now, What I have here came in a set of three, and the large size is 1/2 inch. The middle is 3/8 of an inch, and then the smallest is 3/16 of an inch. And again, we're going to use these to turn the belts right side out after we've sewn them together, and I'll show you how to do that when we get to that point. All right, so you're going to need those. You're also going to need a 1-inch sliding buckle, and I'm leaving a link in the description box below to where you can find these if you can't find them at your local fabric store. I'm also going to leave a link to the tube turners and the two patterns that I'm suggesting for this tutorial. If you will be following along with the instructions, the pattern instruction sheet, I want you to keep in mind I will not be following the order of the instructions as they have them here. I will be doing the same steps, but I'll be doing them in my own order. So you can keep this handy just in case you get lost or don't understand something I'm saying, but just keep in mind I'm not going to be following the same order that they're following. Now, let me draw your attention to a few details on the pattern pieces before we get started. First, let's take a look at pattern piece number 6. This is the front. When you get ready to transfer your darts, the front darts, onto your fabric, I want to draw your attention to this for my new people, the beginners. You may not have seen a dart where it goes and intersects with another dart, but that's what's happening here. So what I'm going to suggest you do is get a marker and outline the dart for the size that you are using. So let's say you're cutting a 2X for your pattern. You're going to mark this line. It goes down, and then it crosses over into the dart on the left side. It continues, and then it crosses back over to the right. All right, and then the same thing on the other side. It goes up, crosses over to the dart on the right, keeps going, and then it crosses back over to the middle. All right, so go ahead and highlight that with a marker, and then when you get ready to transfer it onto your fabric, it'll be easier for you. Now, that will be traced onto the wrong side of your fabric. These lines here are for your welt placement for the front pocket. This line needs to be transferred, these two lines, this one and this one, need to be transferred onto the front of your outer fabric. You don't need to transfer it onto your lining. Transfer it onto the outer fabric only, and we will use this as a placement for the welt. Now, the dart needs to be placed or traced onto your outer fabric and your lining fabric. Okay? Now, let's take a look at piece number 8, which is the back. And I want to draw your attention to this rectangle here. This is the placement line for the belt on the back of your vest. So go ahead and trace this line on the outer fabric only, on the right side of the fabric, all right? Because we're going to use this to place the belt onto the fabric and stitch it down. And these are the actual stitching lines that we're tracing on. So make sure you take care of that. Oh, and don't forget this little dot here. Make sure you transfer this onto the wrong side of the outer fabric, because this is going to help us to sew that V in the right position. You know, it's going to tell us where to stop when we're sewing that V in. All right, and then let's take a look at the belt, piece number 9. You will notice on piece number 9, let's say you're cutting a 1X. There are two 1X lines here. The reason is because we have two belts, one is shorter than the other. So you're going to cut one belt for the left, the full length. And then the second belt for the right, you're going to cut from here to there. So you can either, after you cut your left belt, the long one, you can either cut this off and cut your left belt, or you can just fold right along that line to make it shorter and then cut, because you may want to make this vest again, okay? So you can go ahead and fold to preserve your piece. Now, for pattern piece number 7, this is your welt. There are no special instructions for that. I just wanted to show you what it looks like. And the last piece for this pattern is the buttonhole guide. You don't need to transfer these markings onto your front pattern piece yet. We're going to do that at the end when we get ready to insert our buttonholes and the buttons. Okay, so we're going to save this for the end, and then I'll show you guys what to do with it. All right, so that's that. I think we have covered all the information, so go ahead and get all of the tools that you, or get your fabric, everything that you need. It will be linked below for the patterns, for the tube turners, and for the belt sliders, the buckle sliders. Okay, so go ahead and take care of that and meet me back here and let's get started. Okay, the first thing you're going to need to do is apply your interfacing to all of your outer fabric pieces. And I suggest doing that all at the same time so that when we come upon the instruction where you're going to be putting the pattern pieces together, that's already done. So you're going to need to interface your two front pieces, your two belt pieces, and your two welt pocket pieces. So go ahead and get all of that interfaced, and then meet me at the sewing machine. All right, we're gonna start with our two front pieces and our two back pieces. So grab those, and we're going to insert stay stitching at the neck edge. So this is the center front, or this is one of the front pieces. So we're gonna insert a row of stay stitching from the center front all the way up to the shoulder, all right? So go ahead and insert your front piece at the half inch mark, and we're using a 2.5 length straight stitch. Okay, on the half inch mark, and just go all the way down to the end. And there you have your row of stay stitching. Now you're going to do the same thing on your back pieces, but on the back you're going to go from the shoulder over to the center back. All right, so one row of stay stitching at half inch from the shoulder, or the shoulder all the way to the center back. So go ahead and insert your stay stitching on all of your pieces, two fronts, two backs, and then meet me back here at the sewing machine. Okay, for sewing in the dart on your front piece, go ahead and pin your dart the way you see I have mine pinned here on the front piece. And what we're going to do is we're just going to sew along the stitching line for the dart. And when you get to the tip, the end here, you're going to decrease your stitch length to maybe a 1 and sew maybe starting just less, maybe half an inch from the end of where your dart ends, your dart point, and just sew right along the fold, okay? And then stop. So let's go ahead and do that. Stitch length to a 1 and sew right along that fold, and that gives you a nice crisp edge at your dart point. Okay, and I'm going to leave a tail because I'm still going to go ahead and knot it off with a couple of ties and then clip it. Okay, so there we have our dart, and when we go to the pressing station, we're going to press that dart toward the back of the, or toward the side, okay, not towards the center front. We're going to press it to the side, all right? So do that on your back, on your other back piece. But before going to the pressing station, what I would like for us to do is get all of our pieces sewn together that we're going to have to press at one time, and then we'll take everything to the pressing station at the same time, just to save time from going back and forth. So go ahead and grab your front piece, and we're going to go, or I'm sorry, grab your welt pocket piece, and we're going to sew that together. All right, take your welt pocket piece, and you're going to fold it together with the right sides facing. And place a pin. And actually, I'm going to place this perpendicular to the edge because we're going to be sewing right across that edge. And I'm just going to close this up and pin it just to keep it closed. Okay, now we're going to insert a row of stitching, 3/8 of an inch, right along this edge and along this edge. Okay? Let me grab my glasses. Make sure when you start or get ready to sew this that you switch back to a 2.5 length for your sewing. And go do the same thing on the other side. Okay, we're going to trim the seam allowances. I would say cut about half of the seam allowance off. Then we're going to turn our welt pocket right side out. And using our point turner, which is this one, you're going to push out those corners until you have a nice sharp corner on both sides. Okay. To get that point out. Okay. All right. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to take it to the pressing station, press it flat, and then we're going to come back and baste stitch. But not yet. Remember, we're going to get all of our sewing done before we go to the pressing station. For your belt pieces, you're going to fold them right sides together, and we're going to stitch the unmarked short edge and along the long edge of the belt using a 2.5 length stitch. Or a 5/8 inch seam. I'm sorry, not 5/8 of an inch, 3/8 of an inch. We're going to use 3/8 of an inch, starting on the short, the the shirt in. Excuse me, you guys. Okay, when you get to about 3/8 of an inch on this edge, go ahead and pivot and continue. Okay, we're going to trim. First, we're going to trim the corner diagonally, and then the short end, and then go ahead and trim along the long end, trimming off about half of that seam allowance. Okay, now I'm going to show you guys how to use the tube turner. And I'm going to be using the 1/2 inch turner for this size build. All right, now what you're going to do is you're going to take the plastic part and you're going to insert it into the tube, into your belt. Okay, and push it all the way to the end. Okay. To where it hits the edge. And then you're going to take the pointy end and you're going to push it in and keep pushing, and it's going to feed through on its own. Okay? And when you see that, grab it and continue to pull this. Now, being careful as you're pulling that you're not pulling so hard there you're going to break your stitches. So pull and then straighten this out carefully, not to break your stitches, because sometimes when it gets bunched up like that, you'll pull so hard that you start to break the stitches. So just be careful, take your time. There you go. Okay, then we're gonna pull that out, and your stick, the point that's still in there, use that to push out the corners to give you a nice sharp corner. Okay, and there you have it. And then you just let that fall out. And that's a quick and easy way to turn your tubes. I love it. All right. Now you're ready to go to the pressing station. After you have sewn both of your belts, both of your welt pockets, and both of your front pieces, I want you to go to this pressing station, take your belt pieces, and flatten them out right along that seam that you inserted, and just press flat both belt pieces. For your welt pocket, you're going to flatten it out and just press it flat. Give it a nice good crisp press. And for your front pieces, you're going to press your dart toward the side, not the center front. You don't want to press it this way toward the center front. You want to press it toward the side where the arm side is. Okay? So go ahead and get your pieces pressed. Make sure you use your press cloth and press from the wrong side of the fabric on your front piece. Okay? If you're going to press on the right side of your fabric, depending on what type of fabric you use, just be careful. If you're using a brocade that has the metallic yarns, you really don't want to press on the right side of your fabric, so stick to the wrong side. All right? Go ahead and get your pieces pressed and meet me back here. Okay, now we have our darts pressed into the front pieces. We have our welts pressed. Excuse me, I've been calling these welt pockets. They are not pockets, they're welts. Okay, so you have those pressed. Now what I want you to do is insert a row of basting stitches along the edge, the raw edge, 3/8 of an inch on both welts, okay? So base stitch 3/8 of an inch from the raw edge, and then we're going to apply the welt to the front of the vest. So what you're gonna do is you have your, let me move my machine. You have your front piece here, and you should have traced the placement line for the welt on the right side of your fabric. If for some reason you forgot to do that, you can still do it. If you transferred it onto the back, or if you traced it onto the back instead of the front, go ahead and place your tracing paper under your fabric and just follow along the line that you drew on the wrong side and trace it, okay? Now, what you're gonna do is take your welt. Now, this is the front of the vest and this is the side of the vest. Take your welt where the sides are angled going toward the left, all right? And the angle that's going toward the left should be on the side with, on the side of the vest, all right? So we're gonna take it like this and place it on that placement line, and we're going to line up the basting stitch with that placement line. So place your basting stitch right on that line, okay? Centering it in between the two ends, and then pin. Okay, making sure that your basting stitches are right along that line, and pin. Okay, you probably can't see my basting stitch because I'm using black fabric, but you get the idea. Place the basting stitch on that placement line, and then we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna stitch right on top of the basting stitch, but we're gonna stitch at a regular stitch, 2.5 length. Okay. So let's go ahead and, I should have pinned the opposite direction, but since I didn't, I'm just gonna roll my fabric and place it in here instead of repinning. All right, we're going to place it right on that line of basting stitches and stitch that welt to the front. Back stitching at the beginning and the end. Being careful that you insert those pins into the fabric so you don't poke yourself when you're pulling the pins out. Make sure you pin your welt on so that you don't have to bunch this fabric up. This is not the way it should be done. I just didn't pay attention when I was placing my pins. Okay, let me move my machine. Now, this is what you have. Okay, let me remove this thread. Now, what we're gonna do is we're going to take the welt and fold it up, okay? We're folding it up along the stitching line, all right? And what you will notice is that on this edge, you can see that seam allowance peeking out, and we don't want that to show. So what you will do is take your scissors, and we're going to clip that extra seam allowance at a diagonal so that when we fold it back up, it won't show. All right, so take your scissors and cut at a diagonal, making sure you're not clipping through the stitches. All right, clip that away. And then when we fold up again, that extra fabric is not there. Okay, so we're going to fold it up, and then you're going to go to your pressing station and you're going to press that nice and flat along that seam there. So go ahead and press that and meet me back here. Okay, our welt has been pressed, flipped up. Now we're going to pin it down and sew the short ends down. Okay, so take your pins and pin on both edges. One there, making sure that this is flat. You don't want to pin to where there's a gap there. You want to make sure it's flat. So pin that and check to make sure there's no gap, right? What we're going to do now is we're going to stitch along the edge here and stitch along the edge there. So place your fabric into your machine, lining up the edge of the welt with the inside edge of your presser foot. And you want to backstitch. Get over that hump. And we're going to let's start from the end. We're going to press or stitch right along the other end. We have that welt pocket stitched on. All right, now we're going to apply the belts to the back pieces. So go ahead and grab your back piece and your belt, your back pieces and your belt pieces, and we'll attach those. We're now ready to attach the belt pieces to the back pieces of the vest. Now, you need to be very careful when you're attaching the belt pieces that you're attaching the right belt to the right back and the left belt to the left back. All right, now this is the left back piece that I'm going to be working on, so I'm going to be using the left belt, which is the longer belt piece. All right, so what you're going to do is place it in front of you, the left back, and remember we traced the line on the placement line onto the front, the right side of the fabric. So you're going to take your belt, and the raw edge of the belt will line up with the raw edge of your vest. So place it there, and then we're just going to pin it on. And you want to make sure you're placing it within those lines. Making sure that your edges meet. Okay, now one thing I noticed with this pattern is that they have you to make a line here on the belt piece, and they have you to stop the placement line here on the vest. So this line extends beyond the placement line for the vest. So what I did is I just used the placement line on the vest as my stopping point for attaching the belt. So what you can do if you'd like to follow what I'm doing is take another pin and place it here just to let you know that's where it ends. Or you don't have to do the pin, you can just lift it as you get close to the end. All right, so let's go ahead and again, we're going to sew right along the edge of the belt using the inside, the inner edge of the presser foot as your guide. Coming up on that end, I'm gonna lift to see where I am, and I have a couple of more stitches. I did a back stitch and then a forward stitch just because that's what I like to do when I'm pivoting on some parts of my sewing. It's not necessary, you don't have to, but I just do it for extra security to keep that from pulling apart. So we're going to pivot and then continue sewing. Stitch again because that's just what I do when I pivot, and then we're going to continue down the opposite side. There we have our belt attached to the back of our vest. All right, and you want to do this on both back pieces, and after you're done you will probably see the trace line peeking out on the side. You can go clean that up depending on what type of tracing paper you used. If it's the type that can be cleaned up with water, you can just take a damp towel and wipe it, or sometimes you can just take a piece of the outer fabric that you're using dry and just rub it off and it'll come off. All right, so go ahead and do that. Now we're ready to stitch the vest together, the fronts and the backs. So grab your... Okay, now if you have been following along with the instructions, the pattern instruction sheet, you'll notice that I have not worked in the same order that they have worked in, and it's okay. If you prefer to work in the order that the instructions tell you, you can totally do that. I went out of order because sometimes I just do that. So what we're doing now is we're stitching the center back pieces together. So what you're going to do, and let me show you what I did with the belt so that they don't get in the way. I just took the belt and folded it over to the side and pinned it in place just to keep it out of the way, so I'm not getting it caught up in that center seam. All right, so just pin from that dot that you traced onto your fabric at the bottom all the way up to your center back neck line. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and stitch a regular stitch. Let's pull this back over here. Starting at that dot on the 5/8 inch seam line, and we're going to stitch all the way down. Back stitching at the beginning and the end. We put a pin in there because that belt is causing this top piece to pull away. So I'm just gonna put a pin in there.
Okay, after you have sewn in your center back seam, you're going to sew your shoulder seams together. So we have our center, or our back of the vest. Then we're going to take one of our front pieces and we're going to place it together at the shoulder seam, making sure that as you place it, the center front neckline is here. Be careful that you're not placing it on the wrong side. And if you're lining up your notches at the shoulders, you shouldn't be able to make that mistake. So I hope you transferred your notches onto your fabric. All right, so line up the notches, all right, and then pin it together, pin the pieces together. I'll put one more. Okay, and then we're going to sew a straight stitch from end to end. And we're sewing 5/8 of an inch. Okay, you're gonna do that on both sides, and then you're gonna go to your pressing station and you're going to press your center back seam flat. Press it open, and you're gonna do the same thing on your shoulder seam. You're gonna press it open and flat on both sides. After you have done that, come meet me back here. Then, oh, wait a minute, you have to put together your lining. And what you're going to do for your lining, I'm not going to go through the steps of that because it's exactly the same that we did for placing the outer fabric together. So for your lining, you're going to take your back pieces and your front pieces and construct them exactly the same way that you did your front pieces, except you're not going to be placing a welt and you're not going to be placing the buckles or the belts. Or you will be placing darts, but you won't be placing the belts, all right? So go ahead and construct your lining, doing the same thing. Press the shoulder seams and the back center seam, and then meet me back here at the sewing machine, and we're going to put those pieces, the outer fabric and the lining, together. Okay, we are coming close to the end of creating our vest. Now, we have the outer fabric and the lining sewn together at this point. The center back seam and the shoulders are sewn together. The only thing open are our side seams, and we'll finish off the front and the bottom. So this is the front, or the outer fabric. Turn it right, or with the right side up, and we're gonna have, or start with the back. Okay, so starting at the center back neckline, open out your lining with the center back neckline, and we're going to place the right sides together. So this is the right side of my vest, and here's the right side of my lining. We're going to place the center seam together with the raw edges meeting, and we're just going to pin. Let's go ahead and match the shoulder seam. Then I'm going to go down and match the point here where the center front starts. Then I'm going to go down to the bottom and match this point on the end at the bottom of the vest. Okay, then I'm going to go back around to the other side and do the same thing. I'm going to match the side seam or the shoulder seam. The center front. Down to the end. Now, let's go to the bottom, and first we're going to match that point. Then let's match the dart. And then the edge. Do the same thing on the other side. Pin up your bottom together. Okay, so we have the vest and the lining pinned together all the way around the outer edge. So now we're going to go ahead and pin it together at the arm side. Okay, so we're going to pin this together starting at the shoulder seam, pinning down this way and pinning down the other way. Do that on both sides, but you're not going to pin your side seams together. So go ahead and pin both arm sides and then meet me back here.